folks, in the following scene, you're going to see Joy's husband, Tony, played by a character named Edgar Ramirez. He's going to ask about why it is that they work with the vendor that they do to make Joy's molds for her mops and her products and her parts and whatnot, and why it is and how often it happens that the vendor also is who holds the patent in the particular area. And my response is, that is pretty rare. It was a good question. I don't know how well it advanced the plot. This movie lost money, and I don't know. I'm glad David O. Russell put it in, and it provides a good business lesson. But other than business lessons, man, for a lay audience not in this industry, this movie had to be a pretty slow slog. But I did want to put you on notice that it is very rare that someone will say, yeah, we can make those parts for you, and we also have an ability to license that particular patent for you. That would be rare. That would be unusual. It's not out of the question. It turned out that Joy didn't need to license any patent from anybody. She didn't discover that until the end of the film. But if she would have worked with me, I would have found out about it a lot quicker and would have apprised her of it. And Edgar Ramirez, playing Joy's husband Tony, says so. That, look, you know, we got advice from someone who's not a patent attorney. Are you sure he's the right person to go to? Again, it's so funny. This film didn't do well at the box office. I wish it would have. I really like it. But one of the reasons it didn't do well is because it's immersed in a very dry, dull, mundane area, obscure area of the law, of patent law. Very few people want to explore this. It doesn't have a lot of big screen sensibility. It's got the big stars, but yeah. Anyway, the vendors that you choose to do your manufacturing and do your 3D printing, do your production runs, do your software development, it's very unlikely they're going to have anything to do with the patent system. I just wanted to tell you that that's a good lesson, and as you watch other films and see things like this, I want you to be aware that if they're a vendor, that's all well and good, and they may have actually filed for and hold patents, although many vendors don't. And if they're a patent holder, it's very unlikely that they are directly involved in manufacturing for the use by others, for third parties, manufacturing products upon which those patents are based. That would be a very unusual relationship. But it happened in this film, it raised some questions, and Joy Mangano, I have no doubt, regrets that she did not jump on that earlier. And I hope you enjoyed this scene. And again, the reason I'm kind of picking apart different pieces of this movie is because it contains a lot of good lessons that could help my clients, help my audience, my entrepreneurs, my inventors, my small businesses, my clients. I wish they would learn from this type of thing.
What did the patent search find?
Trudy just wanted to be careful. And this guy found a man that's in Texas who works for another guy in another country where they have an idea that might be similar to my mop.
What country?
Hong Kong.
The Hong Kong man has a representative in Dallas, Texas. The Dallas man was very reasonable with my lawyer.
Hey.
So, this guy in Texas, we're supposed to pay him a royalty on the patent as a protection, right?
Right.
To be safe from any claims.
Yeah.
Is that correct?
Please stop using the word we. None of this is your money or your business.
But the same guy also owns a manufacturing plant that you guys say that it's cheaper than any other place?
Yes. In California, a metal and plastic injection mold factory.
Okay, so it's the same guy. He owns the patent?
This happens all the time in business. You find the best partner. It's smart.
He doesn't understand business. He doesn't know business.
No, I'm the first.
I understand business.
I'm the first to say that.
Dad and I, we buy parts for the trucks all the time at the garage.
Morris did it all the time. One-stop shopping. It's the cheapest.
So, but is that
That's how we...
Tony's asking whether that's normal or not. It's not. And one of the key errors and mistakes I see my inventors make is working with the wrong vendors and service providers. This film provides several excellent examples of that occurring. And look at the smile on her face, that plastic, stiff, corpse-like smile on the face of Isabella Rossellini. She's a good actress. Tony, naive as he is, not familiar with business principles, is right to be asking this, and they're really going to regret that they didn't listen to him. And my inventors make the same mistake all the time. Not necessarily that through a patent search they found someone that can vend out and license the rights to their invention. That's not a mistake I see very often, but I do often see people just flat out working with the wrong service providers and not recognizing the necessity of firing them, having competitive bidding and lots of different service providers. As one changes, you can replace it with another, or as your business needs evolve and pivot, work with multiple service providers. This film oversimplifies what happened to Joy Mangano in real life, but this is a really good lesson for my clients. I wish you folks would listen to this. This is a common problem. They think they found a good service provider, but don't really understand the implications and all the different problems and possibilities flowing out of working with this place.
Made his money, yeah.
But is that normal? Like the same guy who has the patent, the same guy who has the manufacturing?
No, it is not.
And the lawyer? Roy Morris is lawyer.
Yeah, he's very good.
But he's specialized in garment business.
Tony,
no. Yeah. No, manufacturing business.
Tony, let's quit while we're ahead. I know that you want Tony to be your counselor, if you will, and I will respect that. As Tony and you should respect what we're proposing as the lawyer for this whole business endeavor.
Thanks for watching. Let me know any other topics you want me to discuss. This YouTube channel is to help you. This is for information. I want to hear from you and I want to know what things are on your mind.